So welcome, we would begin with the Yojana October edition. Now this edition focuses on the story of Mahatma Gandhi. We have certain important aspects that have been brought from his life. So how he responded to the violence. He classified violence as done by Galton under three heads. So it was direct, cultural and structural violence. Then talking about the 11 woes of Mahatma Gandhi, his concept of trusteeship, based on which you have the current concept of corporate social responsibility. So what he believed was, actually one who is owning a corporate setup must act as a kind of responsible person and give some commitment to the society. And based on that, as of now, we have the CSR concept that has been released. So his idea was focusing mainly on Satyagraha, talking about Swadeshi and Khadi, cleanliness, under which we have the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. The idea was Nayi Taleem, which focused on vocational education, so that at least you have a livelihood to survive, talking about truth and non-violence. Then his various missions, goals that have been achieved have been discussed. Now, as I said, his idea of trusteeship has been very, very important. He observed that the idea of trusteeship was not a kind of absolute concept that was there, but it is relative in terms to the space and time and the needs of the people. So talking about how corporates can actually turn around on a concept of much more equal society, focusing on the concept of aparigraha taken from the Jain literature. The idea is non-acquisition, not to collect things. Then talking about multi-utility concepts, focusing on ahimsa or non-violence was another important aspect. Basics of trusteeship focused on limited creation of wealth that should be allowed, talking about the consumption, so lokanesh, which is the desire to be known among the people. So how one works in order to have his or her standing or the organizational standing within the society is another important aspect. Talking about minimizing the extraction cost and the transport cost for the corporate sector was again a big challenge. You had numerous scholars which were before Gandhi, for example Bhamasha and Mahajan, whose ideas have been a kind of remarkable breakthrough for the development. So the ideas of Bhamasha, his contribution to Rana Pratap was indeed important, and from there we derived the idea of consumption, which could either be for personal purpose or for the societal purpose. So when it's personal, it's just the requirement and the needs of an individual. When it is on a social aspect, it's a much more wider concept, where we talk about social upliftment, talking about non-violence, talking about truth and a benefit of a larger group of the society. Similarly, the concept of Mahajan, which was basically pertaining to the regions of Gujarat and Rajasthan, was very, very important, because they possess the amount of the wealth, and despite of that they led a kind of very simple lifestyle, and this wealth that was created was used for the social upliftment or the social balance. So a holistic development is very, very important, which can run only across the various fields. So we have the concepts like quantum mechanics, biogenetics, artificial intelligence, which are reshaping, or we could say revolutionizing, the scientific studies, scientific world. But beyond that, spiritual aspects need to be understood and maintained. So focusing on developmentalism, then you have numerous group of intellects from the Western world who have come forward, talked about the Gandhi's Hindu Swaraj, his ideas on a kind of upliftment of the society and the civilization. So his works basically talked about how the betterment of the society could be achieved through the various aspects, and those were people, planet, prosperity, peace and partnership, to have a kind of resilient path for a sustainable growth and development. Now when we are talking about thinking beyond self, as I said, there are Galton's violence talked about three aspects of Gandhi. Those were his response to direct violence, which was through the principle of non-violence or Advait, and then there was a kind of sacrifice of self which is much more superior than the sacrifice of others. So that was a basic idea that was laid down under Hindu Swaraj, talking about self-purification. And then he focused on three aspects. One was a kind of violence does not accept any of the dignity issues that are there. It recognizes no boundary. And then talking about the institutionalized systems to settle the issues. Then his response to structural violence talks about centralization of power, how to lower down the issues of non-violence that are there, creating a society free from exploitation, talking about movements like satyagraha, civil disobedience, non-cooperation, where the conflicts could be resolved by peaceful methods and further development could take place. When there was a response to cultural violence, it was mainly talking about the untouchability in the society, creating a much more closer bonds, nayi taleem, new education, focusing on the ecological crisis. So focusing on the concepts of human ecology was important. So with all these concepts, the idea was to move forward towards a kind of egalitarian societies. And for that, the 11 woes, which were known as Ekdash Vrat, were very, very important. And however, he considered, or he had a background of liberal Hinduism. He considered himself to be a Sanatani. He rejected overemphasis that was laid on the materialism. Swami Pranath was one of the leaders, I would say, from the Parinami sect, and this sect basically marked the region of Saurashtra where a lot of development took place, and it had a significant impact on the life of Gandhi. Later on, with the Phoenix settlement, with the Tolstoy farm, and the concepts that were laid down by Vinoba Bhave for Bhutan, the concept of Shramdan, all of those concepts were later grown, and where in the Sabarmati Ashram in Ahmedabad in 1915, he introduced the Ekadash Vrat, which were the 11 woes which are mentioned here. So these 11 woes were really, really important, and he believed that only two of them, which was elimination of untouchability and bread labor, were concerned with the human dignity or the dignity of a common man. So to have that was very, very important. So concepts that were laid down in Sabarmati Ashram, Seva Ashram, all of those were very, very important. Later in 1930 at Yerwada jail, he was talking about the arguments that were focusing on the physical labor, the bread labor, talking about the superiority of the mental work that was there, and how rich considered themselves as the trustees of the property. So what he believed was empowerment of a common man, and that could come through a vocational training. So charkha and Karga was one of the major aspects that he talked about. So we have one of the biggest wooden charkha that has been put up at the Indira Gandhi Terminal 3, and that signifies the importance of making man much more self-reliant and maintaining a life of dignity. He also focused on the issues of untouchability very, very significantly. He set up the Harijan Sevak Sangh, and that was along with the publication of Harijan with the same purpose. So focusing on the untouchables, rooting out the main cause of untouchability, considering them as a major part of Hinduism, and that in front of God, everyone is equal. So bringing in, bestowing the ideas of non-violence, love, and eliminating any type of barriers for the untouchables was his major idea. Then from his life, he believed that truth or satya is one of the bases, and in front of law, if you are true, then there is no reason that you would not win. Then there was the idea of non-violence and peaceful coexistence. When it comes to non-violence, there was the concept of Swaraj, Sarvodaya, Swadeshi, communal harmony. He also talked about the various approaches that led to selfless devotion, and Ahimsa Paramo Dharma was one of his concepts. So spreading the concept of joy and happiness, maintaining peace around. For that, we had to remove out any kind of unemployment, poverty, and have a kind of truth-centric life. right? So wherever truth prevails, you have peace that prevails. Aparigraha was another important concept that he talked about. He also led the concept of self-rule or self-empowerment for every individual. There was the concept of harmony that was talked about, encompassing the truth, and the 11 woes, as we mentioned, are again given here. Then his at the international front, he said a very, very important statement, and that is what his idea was. It is impossible to be internationalist unless and until you are nationalist. So a strong feeling of nationalism is one of the feelings that can ultimately bring in a kind of internationalist views from you. So his ashrams, be it at Phoenix, be it at Sabarmati, be it at Sevagram, had a kind of miniature international institution role play that they had played. And then his ambition was nothing less to see a kind of world blooming with international affairs and India being one of the vital path for it. When the attack on Hiroshima and Nagasaki took place, he was deeply distressed by it, and he believed that all his the windows of his home were stuffed because of it. And it's not only that one country has suffered, but it is the whole of the civilization that has suffered. When it comes to communication, he believed that it's very, very important to mobilize people to bring in their opinion, and it's only through the verbal, non-verbal or written communication there could be any kind of change that could be brought about. A weekly newspaper, which was Indian Opinion, was started in South Africa by Mahatma Gandhi. When he was returning from London to Durban, he wrote the book which was the one of the very famous texts by him, which was Hindu Swaraj. And this was an idea where he laid down non-violent views. And when he returned to India in 1915, his struggle for independence continued. He had a specific lifestyle choice with a specific dress code. And then he moved forward with the concepts that were self-rule, Swaraj, and the home rule. So bringing in Navjeevan among the people through his magazines like Navjeevan, Young India, and the movement for Harijans, that was for the position or elimination of untouchability, were some of the most popular views. According to him, as food is important for body, so is prayer important for the soul. So he also sparked the idea of self-employment generation through the rule of khadi. So khadi mentality, which has now turned into khadi fashion, has become very, very important. Albert Einstein, when talking about Mahatma Gandhi, said he was a leader of his people who was a man of wisdom and humility. So that was the kind of worldly statements that have come across. He was definitely a motivator for a lot of youth. His teachings have been transforming people, and therefore he was rightly called as Father of Nation. He was considered as an icon of peace, truth and non-violence. He is still considered as an icon of peace, truth and non-violence. His experiments with truth have been one of the major texts that has talked about a deeper search for the truth and how individuals should follow that. Talking about alleviation of poverty and labor being much more superior to capital was another important view. So Ahmedabad Textile Association was a very good example where he mediated, and that was where the strike was called off. Then you have the various aspects that he had been identifying in his book. So Gandhi as an economy was a kind of effort that have been brought about by J.C. Kumarappa, and he talked about five major economies that are there. So it could be parasitic, predatory, enterprising, service oriented, or gregarious. So those were the ideas that he laid forward for. His techniques of management were very, very exemplary. He believed that it's not just that he studied law, and it was not just that law has been a basis for development, but it was how you bring forward the management. So generation of employment, creating a kind of people's movement, was one of his major goals that was considered. He also followed a kind of very constructive approach, be it for the sake of independence, be it for the sake of Satyagraha movements, be it for case of any of the nationalist movements that were laid forward with. And some of his major sections were classified under his 18-point program, where he focused and classified on the social, economic, educational and health aspects. So those were the four major aspects that he covered. Then his approach later led to production by the masses and not mass production in the factories. So there need to be a change where this idea was later driven or taken over by industrialization, where we've moved on to mass production. But still, his concept of Swadeshi believed that there should be production by the masses. Now you have various scholars who have talked about, various of his associates who have worked with him closely, talked about how Swadeshi has been a kind of role-changing platform for a lot of people and a lot of things that have come up. Then talking about Satyagraha or mass mobilization. So creating a kind of Jan Andolan or people's movement, as I said, had been one of the basic ideas. In line with that, Swachhata Andolan or the cleanliness movement has been one of the major drives in India. You had various community participations that have come up with political leaderships, public fundings, partnerships and people participation, which has led to a drive for sanitation. Moving on to single-use plastic, that is again a very important issue in India as of now. So that was the issue that was raised on the 150th birthday of Mahatma Gandhi. And the idea was, India is one of the countries that generates one of the biggest waste with 95 lakh tons of plastic waste every year. And of that, 38 lakh tons are uncollected, which is single-use plastic. So there need to be certain remedial measures to check that out. Also, with people getting more of employment, you are trying to rule out the problem of mass starvation or undernourishment. So you have various khadi and village industries that have been established. We are moving towards honey mission for honey development, Moringa plantation drive, which is again considered as an ecological balance. You have numerous small khadi centers which have come up in the remote parts of the world, for example, in the remote parts of the country, for example, Leh, Ladakh, you have the regions of Kaziranga, Sundarban, and then you also have the concept of kullad, the pottery that has come into play. There has been a significant role of women who have been moving forward with khadi campaign, moving forward with sanitation, moving forward with Harijan Sevak Sangh. So here are some of the list of the women who have been exceptionally important and have played a major role in achieving the development. As of now, what we focus on is Naya Bharat Nayi Taleem. So focusing on an holistic growth of an individual, be it the mind, body and the spirit, talking about a holistic grassroots level activity that could be talked about. And here are some of the achievements of the 100 days of the government that has come forward with. So with this, we cover the Yojana October edition. As always, we would be coming up with a summary every month. Now, Gandhi's vision have been very, very important this year. So coming mains, be prepared with Gandhi as one of the questions, be it your mains, be it your essay writing. So it becomes very, very important topic for your upcoming mains. So cover this summary very, very carefully. You can have some of the quotes from his sayings, which you could include in your answer writing, and many more sessions before your mains. Have a wonderful day ahead.